What is CSS, and why is it important?
HTML5, the new HTML standard, has essentially made CSS essential.
And what is CSS?
CSS is short for Cascading Style Sheets. You can think of it as a blog template or window dressing style for your browser.
That sounds like the least important thing you could have with relation to a website.
HTML5 replaces many tags for fonts and text styles with CSS. In fact, you can't really format the text, color scheme, and general decorative elements without CSS anymore.
Not all web browsers support CSS.
They don't all do so right now, which is why CSS is rendered in an earlier version of HTML if you've got something like IE6. But in IE10 and other browser versions, you'll soon have to be using CSS.
Adobe Flash is not supported anymore, and there are still tons of websites using it.
Adobe Flash relies on plugins, which are a security hole and support hassle. HTML5 eliminates the need for Silverlight and Adobe Flash for multimedia content like video files.
That will make HTML5 popular.
And the rise of HTML5 will make CSS even more important.
I know you can create web templates in Adobe Creative Suite tools and then save it as CSS.
And now everyone will have to use CSS, though fortunately you don't have to use Adobe to create Cascading Style Sheets.
Good. Because Adobe is incredibly expensive, it is even its own installment plan of $30 a month now, forever.
CSS files separate from the HTML page make it easier to maintain the HTML page. Assuming you haven't outlined page elements in tables or deliberately placed graphics somewhere that mess up the CSS flow.
Why would that mess up CSS?
CSS can be thought of as a sheet you are throwing over a wooden piece of furniture. It is decorative, but odd legs sticking up put a stake in the beautiful cover you've laid out.
But that's the developer's fault.
Maybe, but the desire to simplify web design with CSS can create those headaches.